Welcome to our today's webinar about instruments and possibilities for the characterization of thermoelectrical materials. Linsei's Thermoanalysis manufactures instruments for thermoanalysis and determination of thermophysical properties. The family-owned company was founded in 1957 by Dr. Max Linsei in Selb, a small town in northeast Bavaria. Starting with the development and production of dilatometer and DSC for the characterization of ceramics and porcelain, for which the region of northeast Bavaria was famous for, Linsei emerged as one of the most innovative and leading companies in the field of thermal analysis and measurement of thermophysical properties. As already mentioned, Linsei has its headquarters in Selb, Germany, with own subsidiaries in New Jersey, USA, and Shanghai, as well as Beijing in China. Furthermore, Linsei has representatives and customers in more than 70 countries worldwide. Today, we will give you an overview about thermoelectricity in general, the Seebeck coefficient and figure of merit. We will guide you through our product lineup for thermal conductivity and thermoelectricity, consisting of LFA, LSR, LZT, the Hall measurement, and thin film techniques. My name is Hans Marx. I'm sales representative here at Linsei. I did my PhD at the RWTH Aachen University in 1994, followed by a postdoctoral fellowship at the Bordeaux University. I joined Linsei as technical support manager in 2012, and today I will guide you through this webinar. Linsei's product range includes a complete line of analyzers, such as differential scanning calorimeters, thermobalances, simultaneous thermal analyzers, which is a combination of DSC and thermobalance, dilatometers, thermomechanical analyzers, instruments for the measurement of thermal conductivity, and thermal diffusivity, the characterization of thermoelectric materials and thin layers, as well as for the measurement of the Hall constant. The thermal analyzers can be coupled to gas analyzers such as mass and infrared spectrometers as well. Linsei also builds tailor-made instruments. Thermoelectricity in general describes the direct conversion of a temperature gradient into electricity and vice versa, and is based on three thermoelectric effects: the Seebeck, the reversal effect, which is the Peltier effect, and the Thomson effect. The direct conversion means that no conventional heat engine with moving parts and which needs maintenance is required, and that thermoelectricity has a big potential for many kinds of everyday applications. Next to already established thermoelectric applications in the aerospace industries and laboratories, current hot topics are waste heat recovery from hot engines and combustion systems, which could save billions of dollars if it could be captured and converted into electricity via thermoelectric devices. Or, very recently, the Internet of Things, the IoT, where remote devices like autarkic sensors and actors require autonomous power sources. Now, if we talk about the thermoelectric phenomena, or in particular thermoelectric generators, we always talk about the utilization of the Seebeck effect. The Seebeck effect describes how a temperature difference along a conductor creates an electric field and in consequence the so-called thermovoltage. The basic effect can be explained using the illustration where we see a conductor. It means a typical thermoelectric material like bismuth telluride, which gets heated at the left side and stays cool at the right side. Because of the introduced heat on the left side, the charge carriers on this hot side gain more energy and move faster to the cold side than the cold charge carriers can move backwards. In average, this means that charge carriers from the hot side diffuse to the cold side, until, in consequence, an electrical field is built up, which acts against this movement. The size and direction of the electric field depends on the material and temperature, which means that the Seebeck coefficient is a material-specific, temperature-dependent parameter. The Seebeck coefficient is given in the SI units of volt per Kelvin or for reasons of clarity in the units of microvolts per Kelvin. Metals possess only a small Seebeck coefficient of a few microvolts per Kelvin, whereas semiconductors can have Seebeck coefficients of several hundreds of microvolts per Kelvin. If we want to look for promising candidates for thermoelectric applications, we need materials with high conversion efficiency, and we need a way to compare the suitability of different candidates. For this reason, the thermoelectric figure of merit ZT has been introduced, which consists of the Seebeck coefficient by square, the electrical conductivity which is given in Siemens per meter, and the thermal conductivity which is given in watt per meter Kelvin. As the aim to maximize the figure of merit, it can be directly seen that for a high conversion efficiency, the Seebeck coefficient has to be as large as possible. But this is not the only important material parameter. In addition, the electrical conductivity of the materials needs to be big enough to drive a sufficient current, and the thermal conductivity needs to be small enough to allow the buildup of a sufficient temperature gradient along the sample. The most common way to determine the ZT value of a sample is to measure all single properties and to calculate the ZT value. For the Seebeck coefficient and electrical resistivity, measurement a four-point probe setup in combination with thermocouples like the LSR is typically used, and for the thermal conductivity, the laser flash is the most common technique. But as a laser flash measures the thermal diffusivity, thermal conductivity is calculated by multiplication with the material's density and specific heat capacity Cp. Another way is to measure the ZT value directly by using the Harman technique. It means with our LSR platform in combination with our patented sample holder. This can be a powerful tool, but is applicable only for smaller quantity of samples and a limited temperature range. In practice, the conversion of heat into electricity is not performed by a single element, but by thermoelectric modules. If many thermoelements, usually varying p-type and n-type, are interconnected thermally in parallel and electrically in line, this setup is called a module, which can be seen in the illustration. These modules can either be used for the conversion of heat into electricity, as thermoelectric generator TEG, or as heat pump in order to create a heat flux, in this case called Peltier element. Peltier elements are often used for temperature sensitive applications like lasers or in laboratory environments, for example in experimental setups. The thermoelectric conversion efficiency of a module can theoretically be calculated using the average ZT values of the N and P type lags, or by particularly measuring the electrical power output at a given thermal load. Next to the maximization of the thermoelectric conversion efficiency, material stability, costs, and health issues are in the aim of research and quality control. For this task, Linzeiss has the most comprehensive and advanced product lineup worldwide. We are partners of institutes, universities, and companies since more than 60 years and have a focus on thermoelectrics with the most innovative concepts since more than 10 years. We support the community from basic material research using LSR, LFA, and ACTS to module testing using our TEG and TIM testers. From cryogenic temperatures up to 1500 centigrades and from bulk to nanometer size thin films, using TFA and TFLFA. The first step of developing a high-efficient thermoelectric generator is to look for good thermoelectric materials with a large Seebeck coefficient and electrical conductivity, and low thermal conductivity. The most promising thermoelectric materials can be found in the groups of semiconductors and semi-metals. The aim is to optimize these materials in order to increase the power factor, that's how the numerator is called, and reduce the thermal conductivity. For this, many different approaches, like alloying, the implementation of additional scattering sources in form of nanoparticles, superlattices, or composites, have been investigated and developed. Our task within this process is to support the efforts by delivering high-quality measurement systems to make the results of the research visible and comparable. For the determination of the ZT value of a thermal element, we offer two main platforms, the LFA and the LSR platform, where the LFA platform measures the thermal transport properties and the LSR platform measures the electrical transport properties. Both systems are very major, exist since a long time, and are widespread within the thermoelectric community. The laser flash method is a standardized technique which uses a light source, a laser or xenon lamp, to contactless heat the backside of a round or square-shaped sample and measures the time dependency of the occurring temperature rise on the front side of the sample. This dependency can be used to determine the sample's thermal diffusivity. The big advantage of this technique is that it can be used for a very broad range of applications, from cryogenic temperatures up to 2800 centigrades, for bulk materials, as well as micrometer thick films, and from low thermal conductivity materials to diamonds. On the backside, the LFA technique measures the thermal diffusivity, but not the thermal conductivity. Nevertheless, both properties are linked by the density and specific heat capacity. The LSR platform is our standard instrument for the characterization of the Seebeck coefficient and electric resistivity. It can be used to characterize a broad range of samples, from typical bar-shaped legs to round disks, which can also be used in a laser flash analyzer, but also for real thin films. The platform can be equipped with a low-temperature furnace for measurements under cryogenic temperatures, or several high-temperature furnaces, which are either optimized for fast heating and cooling rates, or for a maximum temperature of up to 1500 centigrades. In addition, we offer a high-resistance add-on, which allows the characterization of high-resistive materials, a camera option for highest accuracy resistivity measurements, many different thermocouple options for all kinds of Seebeck coefficient measurements, as well as our patented Harman adapter for direct ZT measurements according to the Harman technique. The product lineup is rounded off by the highly integrated LZT platform, which combines a LFA with laser source and LSR unit in one. The result is a powerful tool which saves cost and lab space, and is ideal for the research community where a high sample throughput is less important. In addition to the commonly used characterization techniques, Linseis offers another product line perfectly matching the needs of the thermoelectric material investigations. With our HCS 1 to 100 series, we offer the possibility to measure the Hall constant with high accuracy. The Hall constant can be used to calculate charge carrier densities and Hall mobilities. In addition, the sign of the Hall voltage indicates the type of majority charged carriers. A negative sign indicates electrons, a positive sign holes. The knowledge of the charge carrier concentration is very important for the research and thermoelectric materials, as the ZT value strongly depends on it. Linseis offers three different Hall characterization units. The cost-efficient HCS1 with two permanent magnets. The HCS10 with a more powerful electromagnet. And the innovative HCS100 with a rotating Hallbuck magnet allowing oscillating magnetic fields. All three setups are equipped with an integrated and optimized measurement electronics and can be upgraded for high temperature measurement up to 700 centigrades, as well as lock-in amplifiers for noise-reduced AC measurements. Another very important recent trend in the field of thermoelectrics is the investigation of nanostructures, as they can possess some very unique features which are advantages for thermoelectric applications. On the one hand, additional charge carrier and phonon scattering within thin films or nanowires can increase the ZT value by suppressing lattice thermal conductivity or increasing the power factor. On the other hand, the production costs can be reduced because thin films simply need less material and can easily be scaled up. LINZEISS offers two standalone systems, especially dedicated for the characterization of thin films. The thin film laser flash analyzer, which measures the cross-plane thermal diffusivity of thin films from the nanometer to the micrometer range, and the TFA, the thin film analyzer, which is the world's only integrated system which allows a comprehensive characterization of thin films in the plane. It can measure the Seebeck coefficient, the electric resistivity, the thermal conductivity, specific heat capacity, and the Hall constant of nanometer to micrometer thin films. Besides inventing promising thermoelectrical materials, the next stage is the finally developed and assembled module. For this, LINZEISS offers the TEG tester, which is a device to measure the conversion efficiency of modules under real-world conditions. For the measurement, a variable heat flux can be applied to the module under defined conditions, like contact pressure or ambient temperatures. In addition, the corresponding output voltage can drive a variable load. This procedure is called maximum power point tracking and is a commonly used technique to characterize the real performance of energy generators. Next to the overall conversion efficiency, the TEG tester can also be used as thermal interface material tester, in this configuration called TIM tester, in order to analyze the thermal impedance of the utilized contact pastes for optimizing the thermal contacts of the top and bottom ceramics to the thermal elements. For the same topic, a DSC, which stands for differential scanning calorimeter, can be used to determine aging effects under temperature influence, for example, of the contact pastes. In addition, a DSC is most commonly used for specific heat measurements, which are required in combination with a laser flash analyzer for thermal conductivity measurements. In case of the presented module, a LFA is also often used for the characterization of the top and bottom ceramic plates. Thank you very much for your attention. We hope that we were able to give you a good overview of the LINZEISS product lineup for the characterization of thermoelectric materials and modules. If you have questions or if you are interested in getting the presentation file, please leave a message in the chat.